This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, I've done several videos on finding coterminal angles when we are working with degrees. So we're going to do one video finding coterminal angles when we're working with angles in radian measure. So we're going to do these two problems on this video. Before doing the problems, let's keep in mind what it means for two angles to be coterminal. That happens when their terminal sides coincide when the angles are in standard position. So that means every angle is coterminal with infinitely many angles, right? And if you remember, angles that are coterminal differ by multiples of 360 degrees. So if we add 360, we're going to get another coterminal angle, or any multiple of 360, like 3600, etc. And you could subtract 360 as well. But now we're talking about to pi, because that's the same as 360 degrees. So angles are coterminal if they differ by multiples of 2 pi in radians. And remember what that looks like in terms of a picture. If you have some angle, let's say this angle here, this angle is coterminal if, let's say, I start at the same spot, but I end in the same spot. So here's an angle where this is sort of my initial side, and that's my terminal side. Or I could start here and, you know, wind around. I still have to end at the terminal side. I could wind around infinitely many times. Looks funny to call that angle, but that is an angle. So let's do this problem. Find a positive and a negative angle coterminal with 2 pi over 3. So this means we're going to add or subtract multiples of 2 pi. And just keep in mind that 2 pi, if I'm going to add to this, it'd be convenient if I had a common denominator, I'm going to multiply that by 3 over 3. So adding or subtracting multiples of 2 pi is the same as adding multiples of 6 pi over 3, right? That's the same thing. So let's take our original angle, 2 pi over 3, and find a positive angle that's coterminal. Well, if I just add a multiple of 2 pi, I'll get it. I'll get another positive angle. And I'm going to write that as 6 pi over 3. Now, if you had written 2 pi, you would have had to then get a common denominator. So I figured this out first. Then instead of writing 2 pi, I already wrote 2 pi with a common denominator. So that gives me 8 pi over 3. And there we have a positive angle that is coterminal with 2 pi over 3. Now let's find a negative angle. So I have 2 pi over 3, and we want to subtract and see if we get a positive angle. I'm sorry, a negative angle. So if I subtract 2 pi over 3, before you do it, look at it. Will that give me a negative angle? And yes, it will. If not, you'd have to subtract 2 pi again. And if not, you have to keep on subtracting 2 pi until you finally get a negative angle. So this gives me negative 4 pi over 3. So these are just two angles that you could have for your answer, but there's infinitely many. You could add another 6 pi. Imagine if you added 6 pi to here. Some other possibilities are 14 pi over 3, right? If you added 6 pi over 3. And if you added 6 pi over 3, 20 pi over 3. So there's infinitely many. This goes on and on and on. Same thing here. If you kept subtracting 6 pi over 3, here's some more negative ones. Negative 10 pi over 3, negative 16 pi over 3, etc. They go on and on and on. All right, here's our next problem. Find the smallest positive angle coterminal with negative pi over 4. Negative 9 pi over 4. So we start with negative 9 pi over 4. And again, we want to add or subtract multiples of 2 pi. Now we've got a negative angle right here, right, in radians, so we need to add to get up to a positive angle. So 2 pi, I'm going to add it to this fraction here, the negative pi over 4, so I want to get a common denominator, so I'm going to multiply by 4 over 4. That's just my work ahead of time. So 8 pi over 4 is the same thing as 2 pi. So I could add 8 pi over 4. And before doing the calculation, will that give me a positive angle? So I've got a common denominator, negative 9 pi plus 8 pi. That's still going to be negative. So I'm going to add another 8 pi over 4. See if that makes it positive. So we've got negative 9 pi over 4 plus 8 pi over 4 plus 8 pi over 4. Yes. Negative 9 plus 16 is 7 pi over 4. So that must be the smallest positive angle that's coterminal with negative 9 pi over 4. Because if I subtracted 2 pi, I'd be back at this negative pi over 4, for instance, if you just added those two. So that's my answer. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.